Hello children, I hope you're all fine and safe at home. I'm Divya, I work as an English teacher at MJP APBC Welfare School, Vemuldevi. And today we are going to learn about indefinite article. Okay, in articles we have two categories. One is the definite article and the other is the indefinite article. In indefinite article, we have a and an. And today we are going to learn the function of the indefinite articles. So what do these articles do? These articles define a noun whether they are specific or unspecific. Means whether we are talking about something, a specific thing or a particular thing in particular or a thing in particular. And indefinite articles refer to non-specific nouns, which means indefinite article means we are talking about things in general. Okay. For example, when I say I need a pen, or I want an umbrella, I'm not saying I want something specific. Okay. I just want an umbrella. I'm not saying I want a blue pen or I want a green pen or an ink pen or a gel pen. I just want a simple normal pen, some pen. I want some pen. And same way, when I say I want an umbrella, I'm not saying I want a very big umbrella or I want a small umbrella or I want a blue color umbrella or I want a black color umbrella. I'm just saying I just want an umbrella. So in both these cases, we are not talking about anything specific. Okay, we're just talking about something in general. Okay, so when you just want something in general, when you just want to say that you want something in general, you will use the indefinite article. So when will you use a? You will use a when the indefinite article comes before a word beginning with a consonant sound. You have to use a when the word begins with a consonant sound. A toy, a book, a house, a bag, a mirror. Okay, so you have when a word begins with a consonant sound, we are not talking just about letters. How many consonant letters we have? We have 21 consonant letters, but here we are talking about consonant sounds. Okay, whenever a word begins with a consonant sound. Here, word means a noun. Okay, whenever a noun begins with a consonant sound, you have to use a. Okay, a toy, a book, a pen, a mask. Okay, so you have to use the article a. And use the article an when a word is beginning with a vowel sound. When the word is beginning with a vowel sound. An egg, an orange, an umbrella, okay, an elephant. And sometimes you have a lot of silent letters in English. For example, H-O-U-R is pronounced as our or R. Okay, the H in H-O-U-R is silent. So you have to say an hour, an R. Same way, honesty or honest. The H is silent in honest. So you have to say an honest man or an honest woman. Okay? So here are some things you have to remember. For example, when you say old. O is a vowel sound. So you have to put an before old, an old man. But when it's comes to one, a 1 rupee note, because wa is a consonant sound. So you cannot blindly go by the spelling. You have to go by the pronunciation of the word. Okay, an old man A 1 rupee note. Same way with a heavy bag. Heavy, her sound, a heavy bag. An honest man, O sound, the H is silent. An honest man. And many people will say U is a, yes, U is a vowel, but then U is a vowel sound. U is a vowel sound. We won't say university, we say university. University. Here is a consonant sound. That's why a university. Umbrella, we are saying a sound. Umbrella. So an umbrella. So here are some more things you have to remember. A or an simply means one, the number one. So we don't have to say I have a one blue pen. You don't have to say that, because a or an already means one. So instead of saying I have a one blue pen, you can simply say I have a blue pen. Or instead of saying I have a one egg, you can say I have an egg. Okay. Or instead of saying I saw one elephant, you can say I saw an elephant. Both mean the same. And a or an are used before countable nouns. We already talked about countable nouns. Countable nouns means something you can count. For example, if there are books on the table, you can count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, or how many are there? You can count them. Same way, if you have clothes in the cupboard, you can count 4 t-shirts or 5 pants or 6 dresses or something like that. You can count. Same way with, for example, there's a staircase in your house. You can count. There are 20 stairs or there are 20 steps. But when it comes to uncountable nouns, for example, oil, you can't count oil, or sugar, or hair, the hair on your head, or air, the air we breathe. These are uncountable nouns. Even water is uncountable. So you cannot say, I want a water. Okay? You cannot say, I want a water. But you can say, I want a glass of water. Because you can count the glasses of water, right? You can say 1 glass of water, 2 glasses of water, 4 glasses of water, or something like that. So you cannot say I want a water, but you can say I want a glass of water. Or you cannot say I want a coffee. You can say I want a cup of coffee. Okay? You cannot say I want an oil. You can say I want a packet of oil or 2 packets of oil. Okay, I want 2 packets of oil. Next, a and an are generally used before adjectives and nouns. Okay, you see articles, you can see articles before adjectives or before nouns, but not before any other parts of speech. You cannot say he is a running. Okay, or you cannot say he is a running fastly. Or you cannot say he came into your room. You cannot use them before prepositions. You cannot use them before adverbs. You cannot use them before conjunctions. But you can use them before adjectives and nouns. Okay. Here also the sound applies. You have to see the sound of an adjective. You have to see the sound of the adjective. It is a beautiful house. It is a beautiful house. The B is a consonant sound. So you say it is a beautiful house. Same way, that's an old car. That's an old car. Because O is a vowel sound, you say, you use an. That's an old car. That's an old car. And A and an are also not used before proper nouns. I'm sorry, I wrote there over there, but it should be they, T-H-E-Y. They are generally not used before proper nouns. Okay, proper nouns means names of people, names of places. So you cannot use them before proper nouns. You cannot say my name is a Vijay, or you cannot say I went to a Delhi. Okay, so you have to say my name is Vijay, or I went to Delhi. Okay, or I live in Andhra Pradesh. So you cannot use articles before proper nouns. So that is the end of today's session, and I hope you got an idea on how to use the indefinite articles. And all of you stay safe and healthy at home, and we'll see you soon. Thank you.